Today, we're going to talk about the top 16 Facebook ads metrics and their practical applications. So let's get started. As you'll already know, Facebook Ads Analytics offers hundreds of metrics of any sort. You can add them to your reports on the platform, but also export each to custom reports, some of which I'll show you later on in this video. However, it's important not to overwhelm your reports with too many metrics. Instead, focus on the key metrics that provide deep insights into your audience and help optimize your campaigns in a data-driven way. Have a look at my top picks. For starters, let's have a look at some cost efficiency metrics. First on the list is CPC, so cost per click. This measures the cost of each click received on Facebook. Combined with the clicks metric, it helps you find campaigns that generate a significant volume at low cost. You can consider allocating more budget to such campaigns or use CPC to test different ad creatives, searching for one that's more cost efficient. CPM stands for cost per mil. Mil is Latin for 1,000, and this metric shows the average cost per 1,000 impressions of your ads. It's valuable when comparing different campaigns, testing different targeting options, and planning a budget for your future campaigns. The next of the top Facebook ad metrics out there is CPA, cost per action, or cost per conversion, as it's sometimes called. As the name would suggest, it tells you how much you've spent on average to score a predefined conversion, be it a landing page visit, a sign-up, or any other business-specific goal. Keeping track of it helps you estimate the profitability of your ad campaigns. As with other cost-related metrics, it helps you optimize campaigns and refine targeting, finding the sweet spot that guarantees a good volume at a decent cost. And the last metric in this section is CPL, cost per lead. This metric represents the average amount spent on acquiring a lead through Facebook ads. Use CPL to identify campaigns that generate leads at the lowest cost. Additionally, track it alongside lead quality indicators to ensure that lower costs aren't compromising lead quality. All right, let's now talk about how to analyze Facebook ads with some performance metrics. The first on my list is click-through rate. CTR, as it's commonly abbreviated, indicates how effective your ads are in capturing your audience's attention and prompting them to take the desired action. Tracking CTR for each campaign can help you optimize likes, like headers, images, or copy on the call to action buttons. If you're not sure what will perform better with the chosen audience, then consider running A/B tests and using CTR to determine the best approach. Return on ad spend, or ROAS, or ROAS, indicates the revenue earned for each dollar spent on ads. This crucial metric helps you assess the effectiveness of your Facebook ads and the overall performance of your campaigns. Use ROAS to prioritize more successful campaigns and analyze the factors contributing to higher returns. Next, I have the conversion rate, an indication of how effective ads are in driving a specific action, signups, purchases, newsletter subscriptions, and many more. Pick any of the conversion goals you've previously set up on your Facebook account. Use this metric to optimize landing pages and eliminate any barriers preventing users from completing the conversion. Within the performance category, there are also three Facebook ads metrics that evaluate how well your ads resonate with their audience: quality ranking, engagement rate ranking, and conversion rate ranking. Each metric assesses different aspects of your ads and compares them with others targeting the same audience. These metrics are crucial for identifying areas in need of improvement. For example, if you notice a campaign with unusually low engagement rates, it signals a need for immediate adjustments. By comparing your performance against industry standards using these metrics, you can accurately assess your effectiveness and prioritize improvement. All right, jumping now to another category of Facebook ad metrics that touch on audience and traffic. The first on the list is frequency. Frequency measures how often, on average, a person sees your ad. Finding the optimal frequency can vary based on your industry, ad type, and niche. By tracking frequency, you can identify the right balance and optimize your campaigns to maintain a desired range. Next is reach. Reach tells you about the number of unique users who saw your ad. Use this knowledge to understand the size of your audience and the potential market reach. Keep track of reach also when optimizing the frequency, so you can ensure your ads reach a broad audience without oversaturating. Impressions are also an invaluable source of knowledge. They measure how many times your ads were displayed and are very useful for tracking the visibility of ads and ultimately evaluating the effectiveness of your campaigns. There are no clicks and conversions without prior impressions, so this metric plays a very important role in any PPC funnel. And now let's look at some of the more advanced metrics. What connects them is that they're not available out of the box through the Facebook Ads interface. To calculate them, you need to connect Facebook Ads data with other apps, such as Google Analytics 4 or HubSpot. The advantage is certainly the depth of information each metric provides. First on my list is Customer Lifetime Value, known as CLV or LTV. This metric calculates the total revenue expected from a customer over their relationship with a product or service. Understanding CLV is crucial for deciding how much to invest in ads while maintaining profitability. By analyzing CLV alongside other metrics, you can allocate marketing resources effectively, ensuring optimal returns on your advertising dollars. Also, track attributed sales. This metric tells you how much sales revenue can be directly linked to your Facebook ad campaigns. It needs integration with your CRM or sales platform, but gives a very clear indicator of ad performance. Use it to better understand your ROI and allocate more budget to campaigns that generate solid sales. And last, but not least, the customer acquisition cost. This metric combines data from all your marketing and sales channels to tell you what the real cost of acquiring a customer was. Use this metric to evaluate the efficiency of your campaigns and track how this data changes over time. Compare CAC between different channels to understand what brings you the best results. Okay, enough with the metrics. Let's talk now about how to analyze Facebook Ads metrics, shall we? Most metrics you can load to your reports in Meta Ads Manager. You could break them down into chosen dimensions and adjust the visualization type if you wish. There are not that many options to choose from, but it will do for basic needs. However, if you want to build more robust reports with different visualizations types and full control over your report, then you'll need to build a Facebook Ads dashboard outside of the platform. This is particularly true if you plan to combine Facebook data with other PPC channels or other apps, such as sales platforms or CRMs. You can't do any of that on Facebook, but luckily, it's not hard at all to set things up elsewhere. At Coupler.io, we've developed plenty of dashboard templates for Facebook ads and other marketing apps. You can set them up for free and customize them with every single metric you know from Facebook. For example, get a Facebook ads overview dashboard and track the KPIs that matter to you. Or opt for a full-fledged PPC dashboard that combines all your advertising data into a single report. Delving deeper, connect to your ad channels and HubSpot to recreate an entire acquisition funnel and understand how data changes month to month. Or try a similar Shopify dashboard tracking leads from the first ad shown up until they're converted into paying customers. Find these and many other dashboards under the link in the corner of your screen and also in the video description below. And that's it. Now you know much more about Facebook ads metrics, but if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. If you like this video, please give it a like, share the video with others, and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.